Hello everyone, this is me, Sadia here, and I'm doing your 31st July reading. Start from the 15th through the 21st of July 2021. This reading is going to be for the sign of Gemini, so let's see what is coming up for Geminis for this week time. I will be adding oracle cards in this reading, but no charms will be added, so stay tuned. And now while I shuffle the cards, let me remind you, it's a general reading. It may not resonate with everyone out there, so always pick the messages which are resonating and leave the rest. For personal reads, you can always reach out to me on my email ID in the description box. You can also follow me on Instagram, where I do upload daily readings. So yeah, let's see what is coming up for Geminis for this week time. Let's begin. King of Wands, Queen of Swords, the Fool. Wow. Seems like, you know, the connection that you have with this specific someone, it's you both have to take a leap of pay leap of faith and dive into it, because there is I feel like, you know, you two are somebody who's very different than each other. One of you is very passionate, the other is very much of a practical kind of a person. So seems like, you know, you both are attracted to each other to the point where you want to take it you know, serious, but then there are differences of opinions, situations, the way you deal with each other is also kind of different. And but still there is a pull that you have for each other. You know, it seems like, you know, there is a fiery pull that you have for your person, but then there is a mismatch as well. Like, you know, this connection is not going to be an easy one, to be very honest with you. It seems like, you know, I feel like, you know, for some of you, maybe either one of you is very mature in terms of how you deal with love, in terms of how you see love. And the other person is somebody who's very, you know, young at heart. You know, there could be age differences between the two of you as well, but it's more of the maturity of one person, and the other person deals with love life in a very immature way, which is definitely gonna create a lot of drama, I would call, because I feel like, you know, the connection that you feel for each other is very strong, but at the same time, it's more of the, you know, you don't, I feel like, you know, for those of you who are, you know, meeting a new person in this week time, this connection, don't have high expectations from this connection, because there is a strong chances of this connection to go on and off because of the pull, because of the passion, because of the sexual energy, because of the sexual drive that you're going to have for each other. You are going to come back together, but then when it comes to emotional fulfillment of this connection, I feel like, you know, there will always be a lack in terms of emotions, because one person is going to be available emotionally, the other person is not going to be emotionally available. So there will be, like, you know, a bit of up and down kind of a ride for the two of you. It's not going to be a stable, joyful ride. It's going to be, like, you know, a headache as well for both of you. Like, you know, it will be an add-on at times, but then it will be more like a toxic connection for the two of you. So especially if you are, you know, if you have met somebody new, make sure that you know them well before you take it to the next level, because there are strong chances that you are falling into this connection, because this connection excites you a lot. It's a mutual thing. The excitement is mutual. The excitement and the pull that you have is mutual. But then when it comes to the, you know, how you want to pursue the connection and how they want to pursue the connection, there is a huge difference there. So there is a strong chance of you disappointing them or them disappointing you in this connection, because one person really wants to take things serious because they're really ready for marriage, commitment, and the other person is not going to be ready for that. So I feel like, you know, there will be a lot of, you know, disruption in the connection that way. Let's take more cards here. Yes, disappointment. There will be a lot of disappointment here in this connection, because you both are too different, But the passion, the sexual pull, the chemistry, sexual one, is so strong. So for some of you, you might be dealing with the Libra as well. I don't know why I'm picking up that energy, but maybe for some of you, you could be dealing with Libra or Taurus as well. But again, be mindful that this connection is not going to be stable. So if you are ready for that kind of, you know, connection, again, that's the reason why I'm saying you not to get too involved with the, you know, this person. Maybe because, you know, it can be, you know, the one who wants it to be emotionally fulfilling could be you. It can be the person that you are dealing with as well. It's very important for you both to understand what is it that you both want out of this connection, because one person is definitely willing to have more than what the other person is ready to give in. So be clear that this connection can be toxic, especially it seems like, you know, there will be one-sided love in this connection. Like, you know, I feel like, you know, that kind of energy, because one person really wants to stay free in this connection, but the other person wants something committed. So yeah, let's see more cards here. Page of Swords, Two of Swords. Wow. This connection, you know, I feel like, you know, this connection is not gonna last long. Like I said, maybe it can stay on and off, but I don't see it to be long-term. Not at least now, because you both have very different energies towards this connection. Your true intention, their true intention doesn't match at all. And in the deck, we do have the Temperance. Try to take it very slow, because this connection is not what you are expecting of it to be. Things are going to change in this connection. You will be happy for some time, but then, you know, the bad cycle strikes. So I feel like, you know, just be prepared for that. You know, it's more of that connection which is going to add a lot of toxicity in one person's life after you start off this journey with each other. So even if you are, you know, already with this person, you might be having some on and off already with this person, because it's not how you wanted it to be. One-sided love, and the other person is more into fun stuff is what I'm picking up. Let's see the color cards. Let's see which two colors could be lucky for you in this week time. Let's see. But I feel like, you know, you will be having a good time together, but at the same time, it's not fulfilling emotionally. When it comes to sexually, you must be having a lot of addiction to each other, but then it's one-sided love, which is going to create a lot of issues in this connection, because the other person is going to be, you know, unavailable. So yeah, let's see. Aqua, experience peace and calm, number 33. Aqua, or staying close to water, is going to be very important for you. It's going to help you stay calm and at peace. Plus, it's very important for you to, try to take it very slow, because it seems like, you know, this connection is not what you expect of it to be. Trust me on that. You know, it's not gonna be, you know, it's gonna disappoint you. Let's see more cards here. Watermelon, have fun with your inner child, number 3. Don't have high expectations. Try to have fun with this person, this connection. Try not to get too emotionally involved, because you have a strong chance of getting hurt. Watermelon, if you like watermelon, you can eat watermelon as well. But yes, maybe drinking a lot of water is also going to help you as well. Try to calm your nerves, try to keep yourself hydrated as well in this week time, especially if you don't have any medical conditions which stops you from having a lot of water. Maybe having a lot of water is going to help you stay hydrated, plus gonna make you feel like, you know, kind of at peace as well. Spending some, you know, time in the shower, or, you know, close to water body, like be that waterfall, pool, sea, whatever that excites you, or whatever that makes you feel calm, you can do that as well. Meditating while taking bath will also help you a lot to de-stress yourself around the situation that you would be feeling in your love life, or that you would be dealing in your love life. So yeah, let's see more cards here. Let's see what else do we have coming up for you for this week time. Worth waiting for. Divine timing is at work in your love life. For some of you, you might be having a reconciliation with the same person as well. If you know this person already, and you've been having on and off with this person, you would be reconciling with this person again. But again, make sure you take it slow, because this person and you are not on the same page again. Like, you know, it's more of a repeat of the same cycle that you had with them earlier. So let's see one more card here, and then we're going to be winding it up. Goddess. Honor your divine feminine energy. See your inner beauty. Love every part of you. It's very important for you to love yourself. Especially, you know, if you are the one who feels emotionally unfulfilled, maybe it's high time that you start loving yourself more than this person, because maybe you are the one who is more attracted to this person, or you are the one who is in love with this person and they are not. So if that's the case, try to love yourself and treat yourself like a goddess of love, and let this person come to you giving you love exactly the way you want. Now, if you really want love from this person, maybe you can start using visualization or affirmations to make this person fall in love with you. But again, before you could do that, you have to feel like a goddess of love to them, to yourself first, and then to them as well. So yeah, this premiership coming up for you for this week time. If the reading resonates with you, do like, share, and subscribe. If you're willing to get a personal lead, you can always reach out to me for that on my email ID in the description box. Till I do the next reading for you guys, take care, bye-bye.